Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a diverticulum of the urinary bladder and the patient has single kidney. The right kidney is missing and the left kidney shows hypertrophy. The patient is aged about 11 to 12 years. Male patient. You can see the right kidney is not visible in its normal anatomical place in the right renal angle. Liver and gallbladder are visible, but no kidney is seen. Now you can see the left kidney and kidney shows moderate hydronephrosis with hydroureter. This is the left kidney. Vesical diverticulum is an outpouching from the bladder wall whereby mucosa herniates through the bladder wall. Diverticulum are often an incidental finding on imaging. A bladder diverticular is a pouch in the bladder wall that a person may either be born with, that is congenital, or get later, that is acquired. You can see the tracing of the ureter and no stone is seen in the ureter. In this case, a congenital bladder diverticulum forms when some of the bladder lining pokes through a weak part in the bladder wall. With acquired diverticula, many pouches often form. Now you can see a sludge ball in the kidney. Intradiverticular bladder carcinoma or malignant epithelial neoplasm arising within the diverticulum of the urinary bladder. Their incident ranges between 0.8 to 8%. These tumors usually occur in the aged patients with bladder outlet obstruction and rarely on congenital diverticula. Bladder diverticula occur as a result of focal herniation of the urothelium and submucosa and usually occur in setting of the chronic elevation of intravesical pressure. Pelvic, that is bladder ultrasound, shows a large outpouching of the bladder wall and mucosa projecting from the lumen of the urinary bladder. You can see the tracing of the left ureter and no stone is seen. Bladder diverticula occur as a result of focal herniation, as I have already described. Trabeculation of the bladder occurs with repeated obstructions, that is another urinary bladder abnormality. When obstruction occurs, the muscle walls of the bladder have to work harder to move urine past the blockage. This leads to thickening of the muscle wall and loss of elasticity. Now you can see the ureter as it is entering the urinary bladder and no stone is visible. And the cause of this hydroureter is severe urinary tract infection. So, as you can see, the pus is seen, thick fluid is seen in the urinary bladder, and diverticulum is also seen. You can see the communication between the urinary bladder and the diverticulum. A healthy bladder can hold 1.5 to 2 cups, that is 300 to 400 mL of urine during the day, and about 4 cups, that is 800 mL at night. It is normal to pass urine 5 to 6 times a day if you drink between 6 to 8 glasses of fluid. Now you can see this is the communication and the measurement of the bladder. This is the communication between the urinary bladder and the diverticulum. So the bladder diverticula are either congenital or acquired. The incident of congenital bladder diverticula is reported to be 1.7% and peaks in children below 10 years of age. 90% are located supralaterally to the ureteral orifice in proximity to the ureterovesical junction. Now, again, you can see the communication between the urinary bladder and the diverticulum. Although small diverticula are usually asymptomatic, a large diverticulum may result in hematuria, urinary tract infection, acute abdomen due to its rupture, acute urinary retention, or neoplasm formation. A change in bowel habits such as diarrhea or constipation may also be seen. Patients may also have urinary symptoms such as increased need to urinate and urinary urgency. Patients with complications of their diverticulitis may have more chronic or long-term symptoms. Once diverticulosis is present, it often becomes inflamed and progresses to diverticulitis. Signs and symptoms associated with diverticulitis include pain in left lower abdomen, nausea, vomiting, constipation, fever, and sometimes diarrhea or frequency of urination. Now, urethral diverticulum is a rare condition where unwanted pocket or sac form along the urethra, the tube that carries urine out of the body. And this urethral diverticulum most often occurs in women. Symptoms can include pain, frequent urinary tract infections, blood in urine, and incontinence. Thanks for watching. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button.